Doe even uit respect, jongens. Doe je pet af. En ik heb jullie een PowerPoint doorgestuurd. Ik heb een PowerPoint over de klas laten zien. Ik wil dat iedereen nu, voordat we beginnen, want ik zie sommigen binnenkomen en denk, oh, we gaan gewoon zitten. Ik heb gezegd dat dit proefwerkstof is. Dus misschien handig als je af en toe dingen opschrijft. Dus misschien moet je dan een pen hebben. En papier. Dus pak maar.
Oké, lekker dan.
Dames, we gaan beginnen. Ik wil wel dat het stil is.
Jurk, die zit erbij al.
Ik wil nou dat het stil is, want dat is ook gewoon respect. En in een college, en dit is een college, is het verstandig om af en toe gewoon stil te zijn, dan weet je tenminste wat er gezegd wordt. Het is een college in het Engels, had ik al gezegd, maar dat is bijvoorbeeld op de TU in 2019 is dat gewoon de voertaal. En het zal steeds meer de voertaal worden, of je dat nou fijn vindt of niet fijn vindt. Okay, I would like to start in English now. We talked about Professor Dr. Bruni from Rome, and me, Amy, Claire, and Mr. Frank Castle went to Sutton Bos and to prepare this lecture. We did. And now, all the way from Rome, I would like to present Professor Dr. Luigino Bruni. En er zit meer op zijn telefoon dan jullie. No, he's making a Facebook picture of all of you. That's what he said.
If you stay here, it would be better for just in case they are making some noise here.
Oh, if they make noise? Yes.
Maybe not. It's impossible here in the Netherlands to do this.
No, I will kill them personally. So.
Good morning. Hello. Thank you very much for the invitation, from your professor, from the teacher, and I'm very happy to be here. I was putting it, sorry, in Italian, my Facebook account. That you, I know that the young people don't use Facebook very much, use other social networks. You know. But I just was writing there that this is my last day in the Netherlands, in a 2 weeks program, with a lot of staff in the university and so on. I said this is the most beautiful moment because it's with high school, with young people. That is the best conclusion of my visit to the Netherlands. With a lecture in English that is also a sign that your generation is very internationalized, very globalized, and English and Dutch are very much more or the same. Yes, but it maybe depends also on the microphone. I don't know. No, it's fine.
Yes, okay, it's plus a big load.
Because before was
you, well, you also have to take. I didn't do the
yes.
More,
yes,
but you know, always you have, always have to swallow.
Yes, yes.
So
I will try that. So. Yeah. Speaking for
you. Because I was also like this.
I'm okay, like this. Okay. Let's start. I know that some of you, or maybe all of you, maybe knew something about game theory or just very few ideas about the prisoner dilemma. I don't know. But it's not necessary to have any information. Maybe this special, the tragedy of commons, can sound quite maybe odd or strange for you. No problem. I will explain everything. It's something that is present in the book that your teacher knows about market economy, gratuity, and so on. Is of course one special topic because we have 40 minutes and we have to make something that is self-contained. And then is one topic that I really like because it's about it's a sort of synthesis of many important issues about ethics, about intrinsic motivation, about gratuity, about of course the environment, many issues in that is possible to present in a few minutes. Okay, the starting point is this paper published in 68, almost, this is 50 years actually, the anniversary. I would like to greet first of all Amy and Claire that they went to visit me in the Olden Bosch together with the teacher. It was a very important meeting for the preparation of this moment. I'm very grateful to them for that visit. 68, 50 years ago, the tragedy of commons. Arden was a biologist, he wasn't an economist. He was working on other issues about population, about many elements that is not actually, wasn't just an economist. But in the middle of this paper called Treasury of Commons, there was an example that today is part of all textbooks of economics, in particular at university, but is part of the mainstream of economics today. The thesis of that paper, that when we consume, when we utilize commons, commons are goods that we consume together, like park, like street, like field, as an example I will make in a few minutes. In case of commons, also a lecture in a classroom is a common, because we are doing something together, we are consuming and producing the same good together, but there are interferences that is typical of the common, that if some of you chat or say something to the to her or his friends, this action has effect to the others. Then in case of commons, there is interference in consumption, and then it's possible that there will be some problems for that, that is called the tragedy of the commons. Because we consume together, we are everybody in the good, within the common, and this contemporary, simultaneous presence in the same action, like in this classroom, is something important, of course, but it is also problematic. This is at the center of this issue, because what is in this idea, the idea is that in the case of commons, we tend to destroy them without intending it. This is an intention, but there is a tendency in the humanity to destroy commons. Why? The example of that paper was the example was a sort of a mountain with a common field for the cows, for the cattle, and then every farmer can bring his cows to the field, but of course the field, the grass is in common because there is only one grass in the field, but every farmer bring the cattle to the same field, which is the idea of this kind of tragedy. The individual benefit of each farmer is plus one, because I bring my cow more. If I bring my cow to the field I have the benefit is for me, more milk, more anyway, beef. But there is also the individual cost because the reduction of the grass in the field. But the individual cost is just minus one slash the number of the farmers using the field. Then the individual benefit is greater than the individual cost. Because the benefit is for me, it's my cow. The cost is for everybody because of the field is in common. This is the tragedy because there is a tendency to use too much the field. Because individually we have the incentive to bring too much cattle to the field because the individual benefit is greater than the individual cost. Because the cost is divided by the end farmers of the field, but whereas the benefit is just for me. Private benefit, public cost. This is a very simple graph. This is the common benefit. This is the private benefit, P, private benefit. When I start, this is like the also the time. Is it? When I start to bring my cattle to the field, the private benefit grows very very easily. Because the private benefit grows. Also, the common benefit reduces a bit, but very, very, very slowly, up to a threshold value, a critical point, when there is a collapse of the field. This is, I don't know if you know the Easter Island, the story of Ireland about how people in the Easter Island, in the Pacific Ocean, destroyed the island with these very huge statues. Around the island, there are some movies in cinema. But the idea that up to this point, this is the so-called tipping point, nothing happens up to a threshold value. Up to this point, nobody realizes the problematic. After that, something explodes, a sort of explosion, but the critical mass is the expression for the nuclear reaction. Something happens, a sort of explosion, and then immediately we go to zero. That is typical of the tragedy of commons, is the perception of the phenomenon is very low. Think about the environment, the ozone in the atmosphere. For hundreds of years, we consume the ozone without any concern, actually. But when we arrived to awareness of the problem of the ozone, it was actually too late. Because nothing happens up to a threshold value of the awareness, but usually in this case, the crisis is already there. It's very difficult to stop the process when you reach, because the awareness is very low before this moment. But here, it's very difficult to stop the reaction, the explosion, when it's already there. Okay. Just to explain you these numbers, 3322 and so on. In this kind of situation, this is the structure of the payoff, the rewards of people. Not, of course, not money, but in terms of well-being, utility, satisfaction, happiness, as you like. Then just imagine we are these farmers, we have to decide to stop or not our consumption of the grass. We know that we stop together, if we all stop, if we all limit our consumption, the field can grow again, the grass can grow again tomorrow, and in the long run we have again the food for our cattle. Okay? Then 3 points each. It's not important why 3 and not 30, but 3 is more than 2 and less than 4, but this is important. 3 points each if we both limit our consumption. 3-3. 3 for Anne, 3 for Bruno, the two players for second. Second, if nobody limits the consumption of the grass, then we bring our cattle up to the end, when there is just one glass remaining. two points each. Why 2 points each? Because of course we consume the whole field, but maybe there are still some grass for a few months. Then is worse than 3 points, because 2 is less than 3. But the worst situation is this one. Because if just one limits himself, I decide to stop to bring my cup to the field, but the other farmers doesn't stop. The people, the farmer stopping consumption take 1, and the other 4, because only I don't consume any more the grass, but the other will consume also my part. Then if I'm the only one stopping, of course it's the worst situation, but I just take 1 point and the other 4. You can say why four more than 3? Because if imagine the case that I'm the only one non-limiting, that I non-limit my consumption, I'm the only one that I continue to bring my cattle to the field, and all other farmers.